Welcome to my talk about prompt engineering and how it can empower each of us to do stuff you could not imagine you could ever do. Because you don't have the skills or the time, but with the right mindset, I'm sure you can. Let me introduce myself. I'm Jan Krans and I'm working for Atos, a global IT service provider, delivering foundational IT services, and we have a team of more than 50,000 people. At the moment, I support our team by leading ARC, the Atos Research Community, a network community of 900 technical experts and future thinkers. One of our main R&D topics is the future of work and how generative AI will shape tomorrow's organization. Yes, we believe that prompting will rock the business world, led by people who embrace the new technology and go where they have never been before to create remarkable results in a fraction of time. But saying something is one. Really doing it is something else. So just for the holiday break, I was thinking to myself, what kind of experiment could be done to prove this? And then it was the 1st of August, holiday time. And since I'm living in The Hague, that means beach time. While taking some of the pictures at the beach, here's one of them, the experiment question was popping up again, and then it dawned on me. The power of prompting has everything to do with the mindset, and the work title for the experiment floated in my brain. Let's call it The Power of Prompting, rocket fuel for people with a growth mindset. Here's the proof. Great title. What I'm sharing today is the experience of this creative digital journey to find out if an individual like you or me can achieve something which wasn't possible before, if you don't master the skills and haven't have a sea of time for learning. But now, with the right mindset and generative AI tools like ChatGPT, Midjourney and the like, you have the power of the prompt, and it should be possible, or not. But before we start, first a few words on mindset. Generally speaking, you could say there are two. There are people with a fixed mindset, boxing their talents and possibilities because they are risk averse, afraid of failure, thinking in problems and obstacles. And you know what happens if you float a new idea. They will be the first to say that will not work because reason 1, 2, 3, 4, or if it's affecting themselves, they think, I can do it. Too much uncertainty. I don't have the experience. It will never work. But they are missing the point. It doesn't have to work the first time. It isn't about failure or success. It's about trying something new, breaking through imaginary barriers. Why would you limit yourself not trying and keep on doing what you always did? Because then you know for sure you will get what you always got. Do you really want that? Or do you prefer to experiment and have an open mind? Take some uncalculated risks, really believing that something is worth trying. And failing fast, great. This will keep the learning going, so try again to improve or do something completely different. Feed your passion and go for it with a growth mindset. Okay, enough of that. Let's move on with the journey to show the power of prompting. First, we have to find a project to experiment with, and it should not be too business-like. It should be fun whilst still proving our main hypothesis. So there we have it. Do you know Tarot or Oracle cards, which you can use to get some new insights for a certain situation you are in, or getting some alternative direction for a question which is hunting you for a while? I guess you do. So we're gonna create a new Oracle card deck. And here's our backlog. You want to have a physical deck of cards, an Oracle AI app, an ebook, and a web shop. And we have one sprint of 2 weeks with a team of one, prompting away with some support of Google and YouTube. All right, first stop. We have to have a name for our project. Instead of brainstorming for a few hours, we could better feed the context of our project into the prompt and ask ChatGPT to come up with some names. And we picked two and mixed it up, and there we had it. We call our project Mystic Fusion. Awesome. But now we need a philosophy for the Mystic Fusion cards to give it a character, and we need also descriptions of those cards. So let's start prompting and putting the results in two different Word documents. The one with all the card info, we ask ChatGPT to transform it into a CSV, which the AI app can use to retrieve the card details when needed. Wait, I don't have any coding skills. it was 30 to 40, 40 years ago when I was playing with BASIC on my Commodore 64. And later I did some lingo in my Macromedia Director. Face it, John, you are a noob on an impossible mission. Was the reaction of some. While Googling, I stumbled on Streamlit. This will ease the workload. It takes away the whole web app deployment since you can deploy it with one click if you have a GitHub repository. Okay, first things first. Let's build the app with my partner in crime, GTP. That were some rough days, I can say. But in the end, it was working locally. Okay. We have to do the GitHub thing and deploy it on the Streamlit cloud. Luckily, I found some guidance provided by the data professor, and I was very excited if it will work. Yes, yep. Let's paste the question. Check if the card symbols are there. Let's stick to the single card draw. Okay, put in the number. Okay, now it's time to tell my Mystic Fusion reading, please. And yes, it is working. It's performing the open API call. Let's wait for a bit. Yes, there it is, the Oracle reading. Let's read together. It's not bad, do you think? It's good enough to go. Next, the real fun part, creating the visuals for the cards with Midjourney. First, you have to find an art style. In this case, I've picked Samsara. Then set the right aspect ratio for your playing cards, 58 by 88. The prompt for creating the images for all the cards is coming from the card description document we made in the beginning. Do you remember? Cool. Now, all of a sudden, we have 52 cards, and it was not really looking forward to do the titling by hand in Affinity Photo. So off to YouTube to find if we can automate it. And yes, there was this great video of Affinicast. Just record one macro, run it, and lay back. Okay, done. What's next? Let's find a place to print the cards and not breaking the bank, since we need only one deck of cards and not hundreds. With a bit of Googling, I found Kuji.nl and created the deck in their designer. The deck should be like normal playing cards, so you can shuffle them with ease and the pack will fit in your pocket. The thinking was, if the deck fits in your pocket, you could easily bring it to the dinner parties or other gatherings. There you could play it together, formulating questions, type in it in the mobile app, then draw some cards, like this one, and let the Mystic Fusion Oracle do its magic to come up with an answer when needed. Do you need more clarification? Use the ebook, which is on your phone. The content of the ebook is mostly generated by GTP and edited afterwards. It has all the 52 cards with description and how to play section and who is interested. There's also something like the Mystic Fusion philosophy. Okay, the app is working. We already printed the cards. Now there is one stop, creating a web shop. It took just 2 to 3 hours. It's so simple with yourweb.nl or any other. What you see is what you get editor. I like this one because it integrated the payment module from Molly, which has Ideal, and that is one of the supported systems, payment systems in the Netherlands, which is more or less the standard. I love this whole API economy thing. So the last step, the Molly configuration, which I unfortunately couldn't finish because I had no business registration. And then I thought, why don't start a business? So up to the Chamber of Commerce, and a few weeks later, I walked out their building as a founder. Website done, experiment done. Oh, wait, there's one more thing. I replaced the Streamlit Community Cloud and now the new web app is running on AWS EC2. Did some Linux in between. Still some work to do like DNS, SSL certificate, user management system, but that's for later. To close this talk, I think it's very fair to say, based on this experiment executed in 2.5 weeks, that the power of prompting is indeed rocket fuel for people with a growth mindset. What are you going to do with your power? Which imaginary boundaries are you surpassing with your projects? So do yourself a favor, say yes to the opportunity to change your future of work by engineering the most innovative and productive prompts you can. The only limit is your own creativity. And above all, have fun, guys. I know I did.